Hello children, now actually we have completed previous session. We have completed negative sentences. Now we will start interrogative sentences. Hope you all have understood about the negative sentences. Okay, negative sentences and how to change the assertive sentence into negative sentence. Assertive sentence means statement sentence into negative sentence. Now today's topic is interrogative sentence. This is lesson number 4. Today we will start English grammar. Okay, English grammar. English first we will start today, and we will learn lesson 4, interrogative sentences. In the previous chapter, we have learned about negative sentence. How to change a statement sentence into a negative sentence. In this chapter, we will learn about how to change the assertive or statement sentence into interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences means question type of sentences. Interrogative sentences means question type of sentences, isn't it? No. And this, so such sentences are interrogative sentences. When we ask questions and when we put the question mark, okay, the question marks are there. When it completes, assertive sentences, when it completes, it ends with the full stop. But the interrogative sentences, it ends with question mark always. Okay, so we will learn about this. Suppose here some example you see, statements are here. This is an assertive sentence. Okay, it is your book. Full stop, because it ends. It's an assertive sentence. It ends with full stop. So it is your book. What we have to do is a helping verb. Okay. And it is your book. What we have to do first, this we have to change the helping verb come first. So is it your book? Helping verb, subject and other parts of the sentence. Is it your book? This will come here, and again, then when this will come here, helping verb will come beginning of the sentence, then it will be in the capital letter. Isn't it? No. So this is, as here it is in the small letter, you will put here in the capital letter. So it is your book. This is an assertive sentence, and when you say, is it your book? And what you have to put at the last? Question mark. So like this, you have to change in assertive sentence into interrogative sentence. Second example you see, they were fast friends. Isn't it? No. So what we have to do? This word will come in the beginning, isn't it? No. So word and this they it is here. This will word is a helping verb, so it will come here, isn't it? No. And subject, so they will come here. They were they fast friends. Understood? No. So like this, you have to change. Okay. Now some more example you see that. Okay. You can solve this sum. This is a simple sentence, assertive sentence. Okay, you can solve this sum. So what you have to do? Can you? Okay, can will come here. Can you solve this sum? As because you are asking question, it is an interrogative sentence, so you have to put a question mark over here. Understood? So like this, you have to change the simple sentences, the statement sentences or assertive sentences into the interrogative sentences. Is it? So now, here you know that as interrogative sentences end with question mark. Now we'll see some more examples. Okay, so when the interrogative sentences in the present simple or past simple tense, how to change into the interrogative sentences? No, when the sentences are the in the form of interrogative sentences, how to make the questions? No, now you see. Suppose present simple. This is the rule. No, present simple. और पास्ट सिंपल। When the interrogative sentences are in this form, so what you have to do? Okay, so you have to do, does, plus subject plus base form. Okay, plus base form of, okay, and present simple. Present simple. Okay, so do, does, plus subject, plus base form. Okay, like this you have to do. When the sentences are in the present simple or past simple, okay, and the base form of the verb you have to use. Then, again you see, did, okay, and did, plus subject, okay, plus base form. Base form, but when it is a past simple, okay. See, whenever the present simple is there, what you have to follow? Do, otherwise does, depends on the sentence, okay. Do, does, okay. Do for the plural and does for the singular, okay. So, do, does, plus subject, plus base form. When the sentence is in the present simple form, okay, then you have to do like this. This you have to follow. And secondly, past simple. Past simple, what you have to do? Did plus subject plus base form. Okay, so first did plus subject, then base form. Okay, when you have to do this in the past simple. Now, you see some examples over here. Okay. One example I'll describe. His elder brother lives in Agra. His elder brother lives in Agra. This is a simple sentence. Okay. So what you have to do, you have to change into the, what you have to do, you have to change into, this is assertive sentence, no? So you have to change into the interrogative sentence. His elder brother lives in Agra. Okay? So this is which tense it is? It is a present simple, no? His elder brother lives in Agra. Okay? So what you have to do in this present indefinite tense, it is, okay, so you have to change into the interrogative sentence. What? How you'll change it? As because it is his elder brother. Okay? So this is a singular. So what you have to do? Does. The singular, no? His elder brother. Singular it is. So does. And his you have to write here. His. As it is given here, no? Does plus subject. What is subject here? His. His is a subject. Okay, and his elder brother, no, his elder brother is a subject. Okay, so what you have to do? Does his elder brother, because it is singular, so you start the sentence with does his elder brother leave. Okay, you have to, because it is a, what you have to write here, base form of the verb, so it will become leave. You have to remove S because here it is not a base form of the verb. So here when you write, you have to write a base form of the verb. Live will become live. Okay? And live in Agra. Like this you have to and put question mark. So understood? Does his elder brother live? It is given as you have to write a base form of the verb. So live, here it will become live. In Agra, and you can put question mark over here. Understood? Now, another example. Okay. Now you get to another example. They quarrel with one another. They quarrel with another. Okay, this is a simple sentence. They quarrel with one another. Okay, so this is a statement sentence, assertive sentence. So what you have to do? You have to change into the negative sentence. How you will change? As it is they. They is a plural, no? So what you have to add here? Do. 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 And as it is a subject, so do plus subject. What is the subject here? Do they quarrel? Do they. Okay? Do they quarrel? Do they quarrel? Okay. With one another. And you have to put question mark. Is it? So this is a sentence. This is a sentence. They quarrel with one another. And as it is a plural, so okay, this is a past. They quarrel with one another. Okay. So what you have to do? What you have, this is a which tense it is? It is a present simple, no? So what you have to do? They quarrel with one another. Do they quarrel with one another? This, as it is a plural, so it will come here do. Do, and they will come this side because it is a subject. Okay, do they quarrel? Okay, and base form of the verb, quarrel with one another. Understood? So like this you have to do it, okay? Now, it's clear. Now we will see the another example. This horse ran very fast. This horse ran very fast. Okay, so you have to change into the negative. You have to change into the interrogative sentence. Okay, so when you will change into interrogative sentences, what it will become? This horse ran very fast. Okay, so what it will become? Did. Okay, because this horse ran. It is which tense? It is a past tense. Okay, so you have to change into the interrogative sentence. So did, what it will become? Did. Okay, so did this horse, this is what it will become here, run. Ran is here, so it will run very fast. And you have to put question mark. Okay, as it is the base form of the verb, you have to write. So as here it is given ran, it is second form of the verb, so you have to write here run. This is a base form of the verb. Okay, this change you have to do. Did this verb, subject, did after that subject. Okay, and this part of the sentence, did subject and base form of the verb. So did this horse run? Base form of the verb is ran. Base form of the verb is run. Run very fast. Like this you have to do. Understood? Now, we will see other examples here. Okay? So, suppose when the interrogative sentences are in present continuous or past continuous, how we will change? When it is in the present continuous. Present continuous. When it is in the present continuous, no? Or past continuous. So how we have to change it? Okay, then see. So the rules are here. Present continuous or past continuous. Okay. So So, what is the rule here? Am is, okay, am is are plus subject, okay, and plus subject plus present participle. Present participle. Participle, as I have already told you, is the ing form of the verb. ing form, no? Okay, it is a ing form of the verb, no? So, like this, you have to do it. In the present, when here, when it is a present continuous. Okay, when it is present continuous, then you have to do like this. And when this is past continuous, this you have to do for the present continuous. M is R plus subject plus present participle or ing form of the verb. Okay. Then when it is past continuous, for the past continuous, what you have to do? Was or were. Was, were. First we will do this. Okay. Was, were. Okay. Was, were. Okay. Plus subject, plus subject, and what? Plus present participle. Participle means ing form. ing form. When you have to do this in the past continuous tense. This you have to do in the past continuous tense. Past continuous. Okay. This you have to follow in the past continuous, this rule. And this rule you have to follow for the present continuous. Okay? Now. Then we will see some examples, no? For the past continuous or for present continuous. Isn't it? No. So. Here. I'll give some examples here. Okay. Suppose this is a statement sentence. They are writing a book. Okay, they are writing a book. What it will become? It will. When you have to change into many sentences. So, are they writing a book? Very simple it is. Okay, and you have to put question mark. Only what you have to do? Are. Because it is, which tense it is? Present continuous. So, it is they are writing a book. It is a present continuous tense. So what you have to do? This are will come. As it is a helping verb, are will come first. Are and the subject. They is a subject. Are they writing a book? Like this. And as I have told you, which form of the verb you have to use here? ING form. Present participle. ING form is what? Writing. Okay. Writing is the ING form of the verb. So are they writing a book? So this is a interrogative sentence. Like this you have to change. When, which tense it is? It is a present continuous. Now, we'll see some more examples. Okay. Kavita is watching TV. Watching TV. Okay. So, what you have to do? You have to change into a sentence. Okay, is a helping verb, so it will come here. And when it will come in the beginning of the sentence, you will have to write in the capital letter, is Kavita. Is Kavita. Okay, what is Kavita watching? Is Kavita watching? Okay, what TV? Like this, and you have to put question mark. Understood? Like this, you have to. Kavita is watching TV. Is Kavita watching TV? Completed? Now, some more examples you see. Now we will see about the past tense, past continuous tense. Okay, suppose example is here, the gardener was watering plants, past continuous. The gardener was watering, the gardener was watering plants. Okay, so this is a subject sentence, and which tense it is? Past continuous. Okay, the gardener was, okay, past tense and past continuous because it is a ing form of the verb. Okay, so now you have to change into the interrogative sentences. No, you have to change interrogative sentence. So what you have to do here? Was will come in the beginning because it is a helping verb. So you have to start with was. So you will write in the capital. Was the gardener. Subject after that subject, the gardener. Was the gardener. What? Watering? Plant. As now you have written in the interrogative sentence, so you will put here question mark. Like this you have to do. Like this you have to change. It's very simple, no? You know? One more example we'll see. The soldiers were fighting bravely. The soldiers were fighting bravely. It is which tense? The soldiers were fighting bravely. Okay, the soldiers were fighting bravely. Okay. Now, you have to change into the, this is, the soldiers were fighting bravely. Okay. So, this is a past continuous. This is a past continuous because were is used here. Okay. And it is the ing form of the verb. Okay. So, what you have to do? This helping verb were is here. So, you have to write the beginning of the sentence. Were. Okay. Were. The soldier. What is subject here? The soldier. The soldier. Were the soldier. Okay, were the soldier. No. Fighting bravely. ING form of the verb. Fighting bravely. And you have to put question mark. Like this you have to say. The soldiers were fighting bravely. Then this helping verb will come. This is verb, helping verb will come first. Were, and the subject after that, the soldier. Okay. And this is ING form of the verb and fighting bravely. Understood? So hope you have understood this chapter very well. Okay. The exercises you can do in your home. Okay. You can see the exercises and you can do by your own. Okay. Some questions. One or two questions I can just give you, okay? And rest others you have to do by your own. Beginning of the first exercise, A exercise it is there, okay? And two questions I'll give you. He is an excellent writer. So the answer is what? Answer for is this. He is an excellent writer. So what I have told you, this helping verb will come first. Is he an excellent writer? No. Like this you have to do. And as you are changing into interrogative sentences, so you will put question mark over here. Okay, don't forget to put question mark. Second one, I'm just simply writing the answer. Second one, you see. Second, they are good swimmers. They are good swimmers. So are they. They are good swimmer. Are they good swimmer? Okay, swimmer. You have to put S because it is S already given. So this two I have done and it is very easy. You can try and you just complete your exercises. Okay. Thank you.